R1021, and this is resolution authorizing redevelopment agreement between the city and Pete Regio concerning 12 East Main Street and our roofing program.
Thank you. This is the first roofing project for the year, very similar to what we've done 17 or 18 times previously. This is with Pete Regio at 12 East Main Street. The total cost of the roof is $23,750. We have been reimbursing up to $11,000. This one qualifies for $11,000 rebate. That's it.
Any questions for Jeff? Hearing none, would entertain a motion and second to put that on public display for the next 2 weeks.
So moved.
Second.
Motion by Commissioner Ward, second by Commissioner Carnes. Roll call.
Commissioner Ward?
Yes.
Commissioner Carnes?
Yes.
Commissioner Cruz?
Yes.
Mayor Downs?
Yes.
Thank you.
Thanks, Jeff. All right, next one is resolution 2023-R1002. Resolution waiving bidding pursuant to section 1-2-45B of the ordinances of the city of DuQuoin for a fire pumper truck. And we got Chief Dakota coming up to give us a few more details on this. This is just for public display as well.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for the opportunity to speak this evening. First, really just want to echo our sentiments and our congratulations to Rich. That's a truly amazing thing that they experienced with that. I've had some personal experience with that, and was glad to see that keep going in our community. So I'm here before you this evening to consider the purchase, a fairly immediate purchase, of a replacement piece of equipment to our fleet. This discussion has been in different areas. I won't say several, but Ruth and I have discussed this over the last couple of budget cycles, Mike and I as well. Previous administration, Mayor Downs and I discussed it at length when he took over. And really what we're doing this evening is we have an opportunity to purchase a piece of equipment that will allow us to replace two pieces of equipment in our current fleet. One, which is a more traditional type one fire apparatus, which is your more traditional engines that you see that we have now, and a second piece of equipment that is a brush truck. Now, the engine at Station 2 House currently is 35 years old. When it was bought new in 1988, jokingly but quite honestly, it served as a truck and a half because its companion truck was mostly worn out when we purchased that vehicle, so it lived a very, very hard life. Its first 15 years of use. The second vehicle that we're talking about is a 53-year-old piece of equipment that quite honestly has been unsafe to use for a number of years, but we've just been hanging on to try to do that. So the need there is nothing short of extraordinary. The engine specifically fulfills the need for us directly to maintain our insurance service organization rating. We need the pumping capacity that third engine provides to us. We are required to maintain at least a 3,500 gallon per minute fire flow. And if we lost one of those engines, we would be far below that, and that would put our rating in jeopardy, which, as we all understand with the major things that have been going on in our community, is just completely unacceptable. So while currently we are on the cusp of maintaining that, at any moment it's possible that that could vacate and we could be left in a real problem. So in doing so, I approached Mayor Downs about essentially trying to solve two problems. Now, we all understand when you try to take two tools that are very specialized and you buy one to replace them, you never completely replace both equally. This is a compromise purchase, but in addition to that compromise, it will also allow us to add some capabilities to our fleet that we currently don't have. And when coupled together, I saw some real opportunity in essentially heading off a problem and plugging a hole that we already have. So Mayor Downs and Ruth have been very receptive to listening to my thoughts on this issue. This is a used piece of equipment. This is a 2019 mini pumper. Obviously, you have no reason to know this, but the market right now is very volatile. New truck deliveries are pushing 3 to 4 years right now. Any stock units are being bought even before they hit the market. And really, long story short is, when you come across something that's viable, it's act quick or lose it. So that's what we're here tonight to do. We're here tonight to see if you would allow us the option of extending this, which would mean we would secure at least the possibility of the vehicle with your vote. We would make a visit to the plant for some follow-up and inspection. We would begin some, I would say, in as much as possible, negotiation on the price, and see where we ended up, and come back in a couple of weeks with the opportunity to finalize the purchase. In doing so, we also would sell surplus equipment at the end of it. While I don't think it will offset a large portion of the cost, I feel like any time we can recover some costs, we're obligated to do so.
Any questions, Mike?
Nope.
Coach?
No.
Wade, do you got any questions?
No.
Okay. With that, would entertain a motion and a second to put this on public display for the next 2 weeks.
So moved.
Second.
Motion by Commissioner Ward, second by Commissioner Carnes. Roll call.
Commissioner Ward?
Yes.
Commissioner Carnes?
Yes.
Commissioner Cruz?
Yes.
Mayor Downs?
Yes.
All right, thank you all.
Good, Caleb.
Thank you, Dave.
Caleb, you good?
Mm-hmm.
Good. Thanks, Chief. All right, moving on to Resolution 2023-R1003. This is a resolution condemning 420 Cedar Avenue and is for final approval. Doug, you want to come up and talk a little bit about these? I know we talked today, but I don't know that everybody else has got all the information.
Yes, 420 Cedar Avenue, this house burned, and a realtor company bought it, and they've done nothing with it 3 or 4 years. They thought they had it sold, but the person went in to try to clean it up, and they've abandoned it. So it needs to come down.
Okay. Any questions for Doug on that one? If not, we'll entertain a motion second to, this is for final approval. Motion by Commissioner Carnes.
Second.
Second by Commissioner Ward. Roll call.
Commissioner Carnes?
Yes.
Commissioner Ward?
Yes.
Commissioner Cruz?
Yes.
Mayor Downs?
Yes. Next is Resolution 2023-R1004, resolution condemning 217 North Walnut Street. This is also for final approval. Doug?
This is another piece of property that has been abandoned. It's set there empty for some time now. We've been maintaining the yard, and that the back is gone off of it, so it needs removed.
It's got some nice words written on the front door, doesn't it?
Yeah.
All right, we'll entertain a motion and second to condemn 217 North Walnut Street.
So moved.
Motion by Commissioner Carnes.
Second.
Second by Commissioner Ward. Roll call.
Commissioner Carnes?
Yes.
Commissioner Ward?
Yes.
Commissioner Cruz?
Yes.
Mayor Downs?
Yes. Resolution 2023-R1005. It's resolution condemning 117 North Maple Street. This is for final approval as well. And you got somebody here that wants to talk about it, I think?
Carl Duncan.
Yeah.
Come on up.
My dad passed away. My mom left with a bird.
Come up here so we can hear you a little better.
Okay.
Yeah, my father passed away and left my mom with the burden of all this stuff. So we had to call Ameren and them. They had to come and unhook some stuff. And she hired somebody to do it, but I've been over helping for the last couple of days. We got like the back part of it tore down. It'd probably take me about 3 weeks to get it tore down and cleaned up, you know, where it won't nothing be there. But all we just need is a little time, just like 3 weeks.
Okay.
We'll have it done.
Okay.
I had to do it myself, but I'm gonna make sure it's done so, because that's my mom, you know what I mean?
Okay.
Yes, yeah, my mom.
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah, plus I don't want to argue with the old man, the Bob Carnes.
Well, I know.
Or Mike.
I know who's going to be your boss, so I know the boss.
Yeah, but I just need a little time, man.
You got it.
And just give me like 3 weeks and it'll be cleaned up.
Okay. Doug, you okay with that?
I'm good with that.
Okay. Case of bad weather, let's go, man.
Caleb?
Yeah, well, you're doing it. That's
fine. I'm gonna try to get it down. My mom's gonna be on my butt anyway. So.
We'll just table it for a month.
Oh, that's fine. A month would be perfect.
As long as it comes down, then it won't come back on the agenda.
That'd be perfect.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank
thanks.
Thanks,
yeah. Okay. We need a motion to table that then. So Resolution 2023-R1005. We need a motion and second to table that.
So moved.
Motion by Commissioner Carnes.
Second.
Second by Commissioner Ward. Roll call.
Commissioner Carnes?
Yes.
Commissioner Ward?
Yes.
Commissioner Cruz?
Yes.
Mayor Downs?
Yes.
Good.
Thank you.
Will do. Will do.
All right, next is Resolution 2023-R1006, resolution condemning 215 South Walnut Street, and this is also for final approval.
This house is in deplorable condition. It's...
Looked like they're already tearing some of it down.
Well, yeah, and some of it was like that for a while. So, yeah, it needs to be completed.
Okay. Got a motion and a second on the floor to do that?
So moved.
Second.
Motion by Commissioner Ward, second by Commissioner Carnes. Roll call.
Commissioner Ward?
Yes.
Commissioner Carnes?
Yes.
Commissioner Cruz?
Yes.
Mayor Downs?
Yes. And the last one is Resolution 2023-R1007, resolution condemning 117 West Franklin Street for final approval.
Yes, this house has been in deplorable condition for some time. The back end was taken off, and it's been left that way for a couple of years, and no one's living in it. It's another one of these that just needs to come down.
All right. Motion and a second to do that one?
So moved.
Motion by Commissioner Carnes?
Second.
Second by Commissioner Ward. Roll call.
Commissioner Carnes?
Yes.
Commissioner Ward?
Yes.
Commissioner Cruz?
Yes.
Mayor Downs?
Yes. Thanks, Doug.
Thank you.
All right, I don't think we have any other business. So on to commissioners' comments, and we'll start with Kalen.
I have nothing.
Nothing?
Mike? Just want to thank Mr. Rothschild and all veterans for their service, and I know there's some other things you want to congratulate people for, so I'll just let it go at that. And it's just thanks for all that the city employees and the citizens did.
Coach?
Yes, I'm glad that Mike gave me an invitation to help with the food deliveries out of the Boys Club, and I'll tell you what, they get some quality stuff.
Yep.
Starburst coffee. Everybody else is looking for bargains, but it was nice and quite an honor. And I also want to congratulate all the athletic teams. Of course, that would have to come from a previous coach. But all the athletic teams, junior high, we placed third with the girls, and fourth with the boys, junior high teams, the state. And I'm going to have to mention, you know which team right now is undefeated?
49ers.
49ers, yeah. No. DuQuoin, it is. Southern Cal got beat. They're out of it.
They ended up pulling it off, Coach.
Oh, that's right.
Three overtimes, yeah.
I just wanted to upset him and all. But I think all the teams did well. And still going. Football team, I want to wish you the best of luck. Final two games. And, the most important play in football is the next one. The most important game in football is the next one. One game at a time. Good luck.
Yeah. Ruth? Yeah, I was just going to mention the softball, junior high softball, and baseball teams, third and fourth place. It's a great achievement and something for them to build on and go into next year or into high school. And so look to see more success out of those kids. October Garden of the Month was Chuck and Merla McKenna, so I want to give them a congratulations. And there were some awards for State Master Gardeners in the paper as well, so congratulations to Pam Swallers and Mary Jo Novak for all that they do for our communities. Okay, anybody in the crowd have anything? Oh yeah, Wade, you got anything? Sorry.
I'll save it for the next meeting.
Okay. Anybody in the crowd have anything? Questions, concerns? If not, we are ready to go to, need a motion and second to go to executive session for pursuant to Open Meetings Act, sections 2C1, 2C2, 2C5, 2C6, and 2C11.
So moved.
Motion by Commissioner Ward.
Second.
Second by Commissioner Carnes. Roll call.
Commissioner Ward?
Yes.
Commissioner Carnes?
Yes.
Commissioner Cruz?
Yes.
Mayor Downs?
Yes.
done.
I'm out.
Yep.
I talked to